Let's go over the properties of inequalities. This means we're dealing with the less than and greater than symbols as opposed to equations, which only have an equal sign. So if we look at a number line, for instance, if we're talking about the symbol less than, on the left has to be a smaller number, and on the right has to be a bigger number, and on the number line, the same holds true. The number on of the left of the inequality sign is to the left on the number line of the number on the right. So negative 3 is less than 2. Now, we know the properties of equality say you could add, multiply, subtract, or divide any non-zero number, and you preserve the equation, which means you'll have the same solution set. Let's see what happens here if we added some number to both sides. So let's say we're going to just add 5 to both sides. What would happen? I'd have negative 3 plus 5 and 2 plus 5, which is the same thing as, well, what's negative 3 plus 5? That's 2. And 2 plus 5 is 7. And so it's still true that 2 is less than 7. So when we added 5, we still got a true statement. Still true. So we're starting out with this original true statement. We add 5, and we still get a true statement. Now, what about if we subtracted some number? So how about subtracting 1 from the original true statement up here? So I have negative 3, and I'm going to subtract 1 from both sides. Well, what does that give me? Negative 3 minus 1 is negative 4, and 2 minus 1 is 1, and negative 4 is less than 1. Is that still true? Yes, it's still true. So it looks like I could add or subtract any number to both sides. And if you think about it, if you start by with these, this negative 3 is less than 2 where they are, and you're adding 5, each one gets to move 5 to the right. So you can see they'd sort of still be in the same relative position from where the original two numbers were. Same thing for if you're subtracting 1. If you started at negative 3 and you subtracted 1, you're 1 to the left. And if you started at 2, you're 1 to the left. They're still the same amount of spaces apart, aren't they? There are 5 spaces apart, basically. So one thing that's true of inequalities is you're going to add or subtract the same number to both sides, and you still preserve the inequality, which means it's still going to be a true statement. All right, so that means if you start out with some equality, A is less than B, and you add or subtract some number, because of course C could be a negative number, to both sides of the inequality, you've got an equivalent statement. So A is less than B and A plus C is less than B plus C are equivalent statements. All right, let's start out with our original statement again, negative 3 is less than 2, and see what happens if we multiply both sides by 2. So I multiply the left side by 2 and the right side by 2, and what does this give me? Negative 3 times 2 is negative 6, and 2 times 2 is 4, and is that still true? Yes, it is. It's still true. So when I multiply by 2, I still preserved the inequality. In other words, it still seemed to be true. Now, let's try and see what happens when you multiply by negative 2. Right? So again, we're going to start off with the negative 3 and multiply by negative 2 to both sides of the inequality. And let's see what we get. We've got 6 is less than negative 4. So look at the number line. Is that still true? Nope, not true anymore. So at this step, when I took this inequality, negative 3 is less than 2, once I multiply both sides by negative 2, it really wasn't true anymore. So you know what I do? I cross it out. Say, it's not even true anymore. Not true. Okay? And to make it true, you'd have to switch the inequality sign. So when I multiply by a negative, when multiplying an inequality by a negative, a negative number, switch the inequality sign. And I'm going to put that, switch the inequality direction. That might make it more clear. So what would be true is 6 is greater than negative 4. That makes it true. So it's very similar, the properties of equalities and inequalities, except when you multiply by a negative, and that's the trick. And you could try this for some other numbers. You could multiply by some other positive numbers and convince yourself you still get a true inequality. But anytime you multiply by any negative number, it's going to not be true anymore unless you switch the inequality. All right, let's summarize the properties of inequalities. If the same number is added to or subtracted from both sides of an inequality, the solution set stays the same. Number two, if both sides of an inequality are multiplied or divided by the same positive number, the solution set stays the same. Now, both of these are similar to the properties of equalities, which says you could add, subtract, multiply, or divide any non-zero number to both sides of an equation and keep it the same. But number two is a little different. It says you can multiply or divide by a positive number. And number three, the inequality symbol must be reversed if both sides of an equality are multiplied or divided by the same negative number in order to have the same solution set. So the difference between solving equalities or inequalities lies in number three. Anytime you multiply or divide both sides by a negative number, you must switch the order of the inequality symbol. The other difference is, of course, when you're solving inequalities, there are many numbers, infinitely many numbers usually in the solution set, whereas for an equation, there might only be one solution. Okay, you want to go on to the next video, and we'll be solving inequalities and graphing them sometimes using these properties of inequalities.